We're seeing significant differences depending on where you are in the city. I mean, right now our heat gun tells us it's 91.4 here on the edge of Chinatown, but the city is moving in the direction of creating more shade, more green space, because studies show it helps. It's another scorcher in the city, but if it seems like some neighborhoods and locations are hotter than others, you're not imagining it.
I feel my skin burning right now, so it's definitely really, really hot, like out in the open and exposed.
When the sun beats down, especially near all that concrete and those buildings, structures and infrastructure absorb the sun's heat and re-emit it, causing pockets of soaring temperatures, what's known as the heat island effect. Do you notice the difference?
I know that it's a difference. Oh yes, and I'm very oriented towards finding water and shade.
And you might be surprised how much water and shade can affect the temperature in a good way. We're here across from the Hancock Tower on the edge of Copley Square. It's not even the hottest part of the day, and according to our heat gun, it's already 91.8 degrees. Compare that to the temperature here in the shade in the public garden. 10 degrees different, and the mayor says that's not unusual.
We know from data in our city, it's been measured that in neighborhoods that have a lot of trees compared to neighborhoods without as much tree canopy, it's a 10 degree difference during the day.
Which is why the city has been working to reinvent parks and playgrounds like this one in Mission Hill, with an emphasis on shade and water. So the city has been deliberately working to incorporate more shade and more water in public spaces, particularly in urban neighborhoods that were traditionally not developed that way.